Close the Vols still remain winless in the SEC as LSU defeats them 30-10. Watch it. Tennessee linebacker Daniel Bitchley, 35, takes down LSU running back Darius Juice, 5. During a game between Tennessee and LSU at Neyland Stadium in Knoxville, 10, on Saturday, November 18, 2017. Photo, Brianna Pachorka, News Sentinel. Tennessee's bowl hopes were washed away on a stormy Saturday night with the Vols 30-10 loss to No. 21 LSU at Neyland Stadium. Here are the highlights and low moments of the game. Best of the night. Sprinter's football debut. Reporters scrambled to find the Tennessee roster after a wide receiver wearing No. 34 caught a shovel pass in the second quarter. Adams. Bootfalls don't need Butch Jones to lose. But at least Brady Hoke takes chances versus LSU. Clicking on Mike Elion's online roster entry takes you to his track biography. Elion is a senior sprinter on the track team who has been practicing this fall on the scout team. Tennessee's Malik Elion, 34, escapes a tackle by LSU linebacker Jacob Phillips, 6. During a game between Tennessee and LSU at Neyland Stadium in Knoxville, 10, on Saturday, November 18, 2017. Photo, Brianna Pachorka, News Sentinel. He's our scout kickoff returner, and he was just running through our kickoff team in practice, back and forth, and the coaches said, we've got to get this guy the ball sometime. Tight end Ethan Wolf said, more, LSU 30, Tennessee 10. Five things we learned in debut of Brady Hoke as Vols interim coach. The fans who stuck it out. The stadium was more than half empty when the second half kicked off. But considering the horrendous weather conditions and the way Tennessee has played this season, it was notable that there were still fans in the stands at all. Fans dance in the heavy rain during a game between Tennessee and LSU at Neyland Stadium in Knoxville, Tennessee. On Saturday, November 18, 2017, photo, Katie McMeekin, News Sentinel. The rain was just coming down like crazy. Wolf said, Brady Hoke's riverboat gambler approach. Hoke twice went for it on fourth down in key moments. Close Tennessee interim head coach Brady Hoke talks after the Vols lost 30-10 to LSU. Mike Wilson, News Sentinel. Once, it paid off. When the Vols converted on 4th-and-1 from their 49, they finished that second quarter drive with a field goal. More, Utfall's blame kick return was on wind, pouring rain and lost to LSU. In the third quarter, Hoke's gamble backfired. He went for 4th-and-1 from UT's 21 with the Vols trailing 23-10. Jarrett Garantano was stuffed for no gain on a quarterback sneak, and LSU converted the field position into a touchdown. Tennessee interim head coach Brady Hoke calls from the sidelines during a game between Tennessee and LSU at Neyland Stadium in Knoxville, Tennessee, on Saturday, November 18, 2017. Photo, Calvin Matthys, News Sentinel. Hoke will field some criticism from going for it on fourth down deep in new territory, but it was a refreshing, aggressive approach from the Vols interim after Butch Jones was conservative on fourth down situations while the team was under his control for the first 10 games. More, Knoxville barbecue restaurant apologizes for spreading John Gruden rumors. I'm never going to be disappointed in a coach telling us to go for it on fourth down, because it just shows the trust he has in us. Wolf said, the ones we didn't get are completely on us. 6 inches. A yard. We've got to get that. Quote. Worst of the night. Vols special teams. Marquez Callaway muffed 2 points, which LSU converted into 10 points. Then, amid stormy conditions with limited visibility to start the second half, the Vols had trouble corralling the kickoff and started the drive at their own 3. Close Tennessee linebacker Colton Jumper describes the experience of playing in bad weather. conditions Saturday, when the Vols lost 30-10 to LSU. Blake Topmeyer, News Sentinel. Many of the stadium lights had gone off before that kickoff. I saw the ball until I looked up, and it seemed like someone was dumping a gallon of water in your face, said Wolf, who was on the field for that kickoff. I could see it kind of. Tennessee's rushing attack. Hoke said he wanted to get running back John Kelly at least 25 touches. It was a solid plan. Quarterback Jarrett Garantano is still slowed by an ankle injury, and Kelly is one of the team's top threats, but it didn't work. Tennessee running back John Kelly, 4, is tackled by a host of Tigers as he runs the ball during a game between Tennessee and LSU at Neyland Stadium in Knoxville, Tennessee, on Saturday, November 18, 2017. Photo, Katie McMecken, News Sentinel. Kelly gained 47 yards on 25 carries behind an offensive line that, for most of the second half, featured 4 freshmen and a walk-on. Overall, the Vols produced 38 rushing yards on 34 carries. More Grumors. The Vols coaching rumor mill couldn't even take a few hours off during the game, thanks to Calhoun's. More. Knoxville barbecue restaurant apologizes for spreading John Gruden rumors. Multiple media outlets, citing unnamed Calhoun's employees, reported that ESPN analyst John Gruden was dining at the restaurant's Tennessee River location with former Ute quarterback Peyton Manning on Saturday night. Take a guess who is at Calhoun's on the river with Peyton. Bart Fricks, at BC Fricks, November 18, 2017. Gruden, of course, tops the wish list of many Ute fans to replace Jones. Following the reports, Calhoun's released a statement saying it wasn't sure it was Gruden at the restaurant and apologized for its part in the matter. We'd like to take a moment to clear things up as well as apologize. We got excited like everyone. Please read, pick, twitter.com, AIYVVMPPKCCalhoun's. At Calhoun's, November 19, 2017. For all those wondering, John Gruden is actually 2,500 miles away from Calhoun's in Seattle prepping for #MNF production MTGS with the Seahawks this afternoon. https://t.co/vwwpfnhkg6 Bill Hoffheimer at Bofheimer _ESPN. November 19, 2017. An ESPN public relations official posted on Twitter that Gruden was in Seattle preparing for Monday Night Football and not eating at Calhoun's. The Seattle Times also reported Gruden was in Seattle. The Seahawks host the Falcons Monday.